Alright everybody, today I'm doing my May theme and it's Mexico theme, and I'm drawing out a picture of, I think it's Guadalajara. I'm using all Tombow markers from mainly 2 packs, but I think I used all 3 packs. It's not an exact picture of any picture, I just searched Mexico and those were some of the pictures I saw, and those are what I used. I show most of the markers that I'm using. Trying to show some texture with going over the lines. I think I do that in some places pretty good, in other places not so much, but it doesn't bother me. Oh, and the pencil that I used, just a Kimberly drawing pencil. It doesn't look that dark in person as it does on film, but yeah, this took forever. But it's really pretty at the end, I really like it. The pictures that I use, they're from Pinterest, so you can just type in Mexico and I use those pictures. I don't really have too much to say, but yeah, this is a labor of love, so I don't think it's that difficult to do. You know, you could just draw a bunch of little boxes and call it a building. Yeah, that's all I really have to say, so, you know, grab a drink, a snack, and watch me draw, and I'll come back on the next page, I guess. Thank you. Okay, I'll, all right, right here, I'm just drawing in greenery, no rhyme or reason, just to fill in space. And I was going to check and see if I had any bleed through. I don't think I did at the time, but I kept reworking that orange building and I got a little bleed through, but it's fine. I made it work. I usually put a quote on the same page, but I didn't. I thought this was cute enough. And I just wrote, "Hola, Mayo." I wrote "Hello, May" in Spanish. And did "Hola" in a calligraphy. It's not great, it's kind of messy, but it's a work in progress. I just started doing it, and I did it in red first, and then I used a yellow to do like a rainbow effect from red to yellow and get oranges underneath, and then I'm just gonna keep going over it. Right now I'm blending the colors. No, I was working out the colors because it was still too red. So I'm just going back over it and outlining it a little bit further out and a little bit further out so you can start to see the blend. And I really like how it turned out in the end. It's really cute. No, I'm back in. I missed a house. Had to color that in. Alright, and right here, where I did May, I use Staler pens and I drew out I used a picture of the Mayan hieroglyphs and I used some of their designs, and some of them are just random, and I used about, I think I used 7 colors, so it's not in a rainbow, it's just whatever color I picked up and I just continued the same color pattern with each row. On this part, when I drew it out in pencil, it looks way darker than how it did when I traced the colors back in. It was really hard for me to see, but I think I did a pretty good job. I did have to go in and clean up some of the lines, but this is one of my favorites. Alright, here, this is the month at a glance. and I'm drawing in flowers. I didn't use any particular pictures. I just Googled flowers native to Mexico. And I just drew random botanicals. Dahlias and sunflowers and daisies. The other stuff, I don't know what it's called. I just thought they were pretty and I drew them. I'm using the same 7 or 8 colors and 2 shades of brown. These are really easy to draw. Some of the flowers are actually the same flowers. I just changed the way I fill them in. Right here you can kind of see how I draw them out. It's really simple. It's just how you fill it in that makes it look more detailed than it actually is. There was a glitch. What? There was a glitch. In the record? Oh, right here, I just turned it upside down so I could see it better. It's okay to flip the book around to make you feel better. To make it more comfortable for you. Sorry it's outside of the viewfinder. I didn't realize till after I'd done it. Right now, it's really hard to see. I'm doing the same flower over again. I'm just coloring it in differently and using different colors. Thank you. Okay, all my flowers are done. Now I'm using the stamps. And each row is going to be a different color. And I'm going to stamp in all my numbers. And I'm trying to use the same colors that I used when I did my drawing of the flowers and the little houses on the cover page. This took a really long time, so yeah, just beware. At this point, what I started to do was every time I would change the number, I would try to stamp that number everywhere it would go, whether if it was 3 or 13 or 30. Anytime I used the 3, I would just wipe it off and just use the different color. Because before, I wasn't doing that. Alright, I'm almost done. Oh, this is where I realized that there was no date right there, so I just filled in the flower. And then added another flower. I guess I'll go back later and add another flower there. Right. Right here, I'm using pens and correlating colors and blocking all my days in, kind of like bubble letters. Thank you. I wrote down Hola Mel and I Google translated goals and stuff. So if that's not grammatically correct, I'm sorry. I Googled it. And I got June. I wrote June in Spanish. And then under that, I'll write any events or birthdays that I have coming up in June, just so I'm aware. And here's where I'm adding in the second part. All right. Clipping this page down, and I'm working on my field notes page, where I'm just drawing more botanicals, pretty much the same ones from the last page, just maybe in different colors. Sorry, you can't really see what I'm doing. I didn't realize I was out of focus. Right here I'm doing the squiggly lines at the end of the petals to make them have more dimension and then I can look curled up. And now I'm adding a second color, give it more character. I have more space, so I added in another flower. I'm using gray to make a white flower because a white pin wouldn't show up the same way. And there you go. On this page, this is my habit tracker and mood tracker. I'm drawing another little town. And on this one, I'm mostly, right now I'm just using the flesh tone portrait pack from the Tombos. Same colors from before. Right here, I'm just adding in greenery to fill in the space. There's no rhyme or reason, and I'm just going back in certain parts to make it look darker, to add dimension. Now I'm writing in Habit Tracker, and I'm just writing it. In cursive. Checking to make sure it didn't bleed through. And I just go over it several times. Just to give it some more interest. And I'm doing it each word in a different color, but using the same colors from before. Since it was a Mexico thing, I wanted to keep the colors. And right now I'm writing in my habits. Normally I would write it and then highlight it, but instead I wrote it out and then blocked it where the highlighter would be. And let the words extend past where the highlighter would be. I normally feel like I track too many things, so I get overwhelmed and end up not doing anything. So I'm only tracking 6 things. Something happened. And I'm tracking social, so anytime I post to social media, my water intake, working out, create is where, if I make anything, whether it's doing something in my bullet journal, or doing something with my Cricut, or just general making something, whatever it is. All right, here, this is my mood tracker. I'm doing a grid for every day, cleaning up with the gel pen. And I'm writing AM and PM. And then on the side, I'm writing the days of the month. And then on the other side, I'm gonna write the days of the week. And then I'll just write in how I'm feeling when I wake up or at some point in the morning. And then before I go to bed, I'll write in how I'm feeling at the end of the day. I can write one word or a short phrase. And right now, I think I'm adding flowers. And it's the same flowers from before. And on this page, I'm doing a food tracker. Because I want to be healthier. So, my goal was to write down what I'm eating every day. And I'm going to do 4 bars, and each bar is going to be a different color. This doesn't signify anything, it was just pretty. And then I'll go back in and use the gel pen to clean up my lines, and then I'll add more flowers on this page. I'm writing in the numbers for each day. Now I'm cleaning my lines up. I drew too many boxes, so I'm putting a big bright flower to cover that up. Because it's not gonna be perfect, mistakes happen. It's just learning to deal with it. Maybe cleaning up my lines. And here's an example. My morning was productive. I got a lot done. The end of the day still felt great. Ended on a good note. And I just worked great. I guess I forgot to color in my flowers. So that's what I'm doing now. Same colors. I'll just color it in slightly differently. Thank you. And right now I'm doing a simple weekly where I put all the days of the week down the side and a mini calendar at the top. I wrote me in Spanish. My goals, to-do list, notes. And eventually I go back to the top next to goals, right above the notes, and I'll write a quote of the week. And right here, I drew in some flowers. My intent was to show you guys how to draw them, but you can't really see how I drew it.